he lives in a house with three other girls, but he didn't tell me until he bought the house. And then the next thing he did was to, he told me that he's gonna room with that one of the girls. And then I was just like,
hi, Malcolm.
Hi, I'm Denise. Mel and I are in a relationship for the past 2 years, and we were in a long-distance relationship for 9 months. Hi, I'm Joey.
And I'm Rung Tien.
We've been together for about 4 years, and we were in an LDR for 1 year.
Hi, my name is Kritika.
Hi, I'm Pranav. So we've been dating for a little less than 5 years.
And our long-distance was for about a year and a half.
So in the first part of our LDR, he was in the Netherlands on exchange and I was on internship in Sweden, and that was for about 5 to 6 months. And then the second part of LDR, he flew back to Singapore while I was still in Sweden, so that lasted for about 7 to 8 months. I was a little bit worried lah, because there would be like, physically we couldn't be together for a few months to a year, right? Even though we were both in Europe, we were still not in the same country. What I did was, I printed all the pictures that we took together when we were overseas, and then I put it in a bulletin board for him. Yeah, so I gave it to him on the last time we met.
In Sweden.
So like, he can take it back and like, kind of remember me. So that he will miss me for the next 7 to 8 months before I can see him again.
We were together for about 3 months before our first LDR.
So I work in New York City, so once in a while I have to fly over to New York for 1 to 2 month durations. And early this year, he actually went for his university exchange to Netherlands. I think it was something I made super clear even before we got together. I was like, hey.
The biggest worry that we had was more of getting cheated on. I think it's because both of us have gone through like something similar in the past before getting together.
Honestly, apart from that, I had like full trust in like our relationship and you as a person. So honestly, I wasn't really worried.
Cool.
Thank you.
Right
now. So we went to the same uni. I was a year senior to her. Both of us were in India. So she was in college, which was in Bellore. I stayed in Chennai. So it's around three and a half hours away.
I'm from Singapore and he's from India. So we didn't know when it would end or if it will go on forever. So I think that was scary for me.
Right before I knew I was going to go work, so we went to all the places we always used to hang out and where we used to go for like lunches, and we did all of that. And I used to tell her, I used to be like, yeah, it's 3 hours away. I could come down whenever you want. Every weekend I'll probably be there. But that obviously didn't happen.
Yeah, we just spent a lot of time doing things together in the last one month.
We are both not that kind of people who are like so scheduled. So we just text and call whenever we feel like it lah.
I think it was easier for us to text or video call when we were both in Europe because of the time zone. But when I came back to Singapore, it became a bit harder because after she end work, there's about maybe 6, 7pm in Sweden, and in Singapore it's already like 12, 1am and stuff like that.
I was working, so I used to go to a lot of sites in the morning, so I had to drive around a lot. So what I used to do is, I had a timetable for all our classes, so I knew exactly when she got off. So I would try calling her, and each time I drove, I would call her respective, so I could just speak to her like while I'm doing my work, during lunch.
We would spend a lot of time FaceTiming. Usually I would stay up until like 4 or 5 a.m. so that I could keep up with her day, and then I'll just go to sleep for until I have class, and then I'll go for class, and then kind of like the cycle repeats itself.
I think these small little moments to really catch up on our day and to talk to each other were really important, because at least when I'm overseas, I was always very busy. I had a lot to do. It was just reassuring to know that to just have someone there looking out for me, even if we weren't necessarily talking about anything.
I used to sleep very early. I sleep at like
so
10, 10:30. So whenever he would want to do like a video call at night, which is when he's free, I would usually be sleeping. Or I would pick up the call, then I would talk, then I would sleep. So it was quite hard aligning our time.
So that used to be really difficult. And that's one thing we used to fight about. Okay? I'm like, stay up. And she's like, no, I need sleep.
I couldn't make time, so then I had to work on that as well.
especially for the second part of the LDR, I felt it more lah. So I think I would text him more often that, you know, I was feeling sad and all that stuff. So I think after a while he got a bit annoyed.
I got meh.
Like he got a bit annoyed like that I kept saying that I felt sad over this LDR thing. I even asked him like, do you want to go come Portugal and find me? Then he was like, no money.
I think the biggest challenge I faced was insecurity, like way at the start, because of like past experiences and whatnot. And Denise was like meeting new people and everything.
Yeah, I think it's pretty common. The person flying seems to have like an easier time because, you know, they're in like, a new place and a new environment, whereas it's a bit tougher for the partners who is back at home. So I did everything that I possibly could to really reassure him, to make sure that I'm safe, to share with him who I'm meeting and what I'm up to. Vice versa, when he was away in Netherlands, he was also reassuring me like who was he meeting, which parties were he going to, and stuff like
None.
That. He lived in a house with three other girls, but he didn't tell me until he got the house.
Okay, it was my mistake.
And then he was like, yeah, it's not a good thing. And then the next thing he did was to, he told me like he's got a room with that one of the girls. And then I was just like,
okay, the compromise in the end was I slept in the kitchen. I put the bed like right beside the kitchen.
He took out the mattress.
It was kind of a comfortable experience still. Not too bad. I'll just do it. I'll just do it.
He didn't even tell me.
Just like a funny story. Like, cause like she kind of blocked like me and her family members from her Instagram stories. So she kind of like flew back one day before. So everyone kind of knew. I said about me and her family. So like our group of friends, like the hall friends, they were like saying, hey Rentin, let's go club one last time. Like last night of freedom.
So I went to his workplace to surprise him. And then he just like looked at them shocked.
Are you sure? Is it only tomorrow?
He said he's happy, but then like I guess he's supposed to enjoy one last night of freedom before I came back last. So I guess I spoiled his plans.
I think the first time we met up, he had to drive down for 4 hours and he had to drive back the same day. So it was a surprise. I was obviously happy that he drove down to see me, but he only had 2 hours to see me. And that 2 hours I was busy, I actually had something to do. So I was very annoyed.
She's like, you come down to me for 2 hours. I'm like, yeah, like there's only 24 hours in a day. I can't do more.
I was just disappointed that I couldn't be with you for the 2 hours and he didn't let me know. But then I failed to realize that it was such a nice thing that he drove down for 4 hours to surprise me.
Because she always says, okay, like you never surprise me. I always ask for it. Then I come surprise her and she's like, 2 hours. And I'm like,
yeah. He never surprises me, so when he did surprise me, I was more focused on how it went wrong than the fact that he surprised me. Yeah, I should have done that.
Good.
She forgot how I looked like.
I was just like, I saw him and I was very
She just stared at me and then she was like, I was like, it's me, your boyfriend.
Yeah, and then like when we hugged, I was like, yeah, it was really weird. It took me like, I think a few hours.
A few hours?
Yeah.
I thought it was minutes.
No, it was a while. I was like, this is...
Okay.
And I don't know why. I don't know.
We saw each other every day on FaceTime, by the way.
Yeah. But then when I met him in person, I just got really awkward. I was like meeting like a new person again for the first time.
I think it's important to let the other person know that you're thinking of them throughout the day, because I noticed that when I did that, he used to feel happy and he used to tell me that he had a better day.
I'd say just don't go to bed angry. If you had a fight today, say your sorries before you go to bed, because sometimes when you're not next to each other, you'd fight, you'd sleep and you'd forget why you fought. You just remember that you're angry. So I think it's important for us not to feel that way.
If your LDR is not a permanent LDR, you need to keep that in mind, that this is not going to be a permanent fixture. So, like, do what you can to tide through these months or even years and know that there is something that is waiting for you at the end of your journey. Because a lot of people just get sucked into the fact that they don't believe in LDR because they think that they cannot handle the separation. But for me, I feel that if it's not a permanent separation, then why are you so worried? Also, I think social media can be quite toxic. Like, social media is not everything.
You don't really have to answer to these people. for a relationship. Like, you just need to answer to each other. I think that's all that matters, lor.
You don't need to seek validation from other people, yeah, whether your relationship's okay or not.
Just don't be stupid. You're not stupid and can't really.
I think what's important is that you figure out what helps your relationship stay transparent. And I think most importantly is to focus on the love and the trust you have for each other rather than the fears and the worries that tend to come about, because the love will conquer all.
Love wins. Love conquers all.
Thank you for watching this video.
And let us know in the comments what you want to see next.
Don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Bye!